This segment of the interview with Muse Watson is sponsored by John Lobbin Creative, graphic design for print and web, and quality printed and promotional products available at johnlobbin.com. Ross is asking, what's next for you, Muse? More TV, film, or something different? Something new?
I have both in the preparatory developmental stages. One of the reasons why I'm letting this grow out is because there's a possibility of me being on TV as a judge, and so I'm waiting to hear about that. There's also two films that are lined up that I'm supposed to go to, another one in New Orleans, and so I'm waiting to hear on that. So there was a whole lot of difference in the difference between shooting movies and shooting TV. Shooting TV, we used to shoot 10, 12 pages a day of the script. And on movies, we'd shoot 2 to 3 pages a day, which meant that the schedule was a lot slower and there was a lot more time for nuance. Back in those days, we called made-for-TV movies, we called them 28-day wonders because we shot them in 28 days. You would be amazed at how many feature films this day and time are shot in 28 days or less. And so it's getting to be where there's not a whole lot of difference between shooting movies and shooting TV, particularly when you compare it to shooting something like NCIS, which is shot sort of the way old movies was shot, with a lot of nuance, a lot of lighting setups, and a lot of subtlety. And, when you compare shooting NCIS to shooting like a $12 million independent film, the independent film is shot more like television than NCIS is.
We've got a question from Jasmine I'll take real quick here. She's asking, is that really you on Twitter?
Go on Twitter and ask me a question only I would know. I'll have to say, there are times when I get up and get on Twitter and I do feel like maybe Mike has conjured my body or something. Because some of the things that I've said on Twitter are more like Mike than they are like me. Facebook was very interesting to me because, being a 24-year recovering alcoholic, there were a lot of people that I owed amends to, that I needed to say I was sorry to. And I found a lot of those folks on Facebook that I would have never been able to find in person, nor have an opportunity. And when I found those people from my past on Facebook, I was able to go to them in print on the internet and apologize to them and tell them that I was sorry for my behavior. And so Facebook has been, in that respect, a real spiritual tool for me. And I appreciate that. I haven't run into people on, Twitter's not the same thing. I haven't run into people on Twitter that I knew, like years ago or people from years ago. There's almost 10,000 people follow me on Twitter, so I got no handle on who it is. When I was in college, my roommate, my freshman year in college, was a radio DJ, and I used to write jingles for him. And Twitter is an expression of that for me now. I get to write radio jingles and put them on as twits.
Question from Megan. What do you enjoy doing in your spare time? We touched on this a little earlier, but real briefly. When you're not working, what are you doing for fun?
I pull my daughter around the neighborhood in a wagon. She and I watch Elmo, stuff like that. I don't, now that I'm a father and I take the role very seriously, I don't have a lot of free time.
All right. Sherry is asking, do you make your own Facebook posts?
Yes, I do make, some of them are mine. Priscilla, my assistant, also does some. to keep people informed and videos and stuff like that, Priscilla will post some, but mostly it's me.
Okay. And on Twitter, Jana makes a comment. Trust me, it's him on Twitter. I talk to him often, and he acknowledged me earlier in the show.
That's
Mike King
true.
Has a comment.
Very true.
He says, Muse, you come across extremely thoughtful, polite, and learned. Thank you for very much for attending tonight.
Well, let me just tell Mike, I'm a slow learner, and I came through years as a jackass. And I had a period of time coming out of alcohol and finding out what a real spiritual life was about, that the important things in life are what we give to other people. And I hope to do that today. And I thank you for your comment.
A question here from Kathy Kaufman. What's your favorite sport, soccer, okay. basketball, or football?
Football.
What were you like in high school? That's a good question. Other than playing in band.
I wish I knew. My father passed away when I was 6 years old, and I was sad. I was sad. My mother was depressed, and I was very sad too. I don't know exactly what I was like in school. I know I was quiet. I know I wasn't the valedictorian for sure because I was dyslexic, ambidextrous, and didn't make good grades. And being in the band, I was kind of nerdy, I guess. I don't know. I can tell you this. I wasn't a very big fella. I was a little fella. But you didn't want to mess with me because... if you whipped me, you'd have to whip me all day long, because as I was laying on the ground, beat half to death, I'd get up and hit you again. I think that was part of the little tiny boy in me that became the fella capable of playing Mike Franks. Believe me, I got whipped a bunch. I was not a very big fella, but I didn't let that stop me from trying. I mean, if you were going to whip me, you better kill me, because I was going to be after you. And that's about all I remember about high school.
Kathy also asked, did you see yourself as an actor when you were younger? Had you had any thoughts like that when you were younger, or any desires, or was that just totally when you were in college?
I wanted to go to law school. And after I found out that there were only two ways to become an FBI agent, one was to be a CPA, an accountant, mm-hmm. and the other one was to go to law school. My goal, as I remember writing it out as my career goal in school, was to go to law school and then join the FBI.
So FBI was one of your aspirations from an earlier, younger age?
Yes. Yes.
Question from Ross. Have any of your roles been written specifically for you or with you in mind?
I know there have been. I just don't know if they're films that you would have seen. I know there was a short that was written that I did where I played a preacher. I know that there was, but I'm not sure any of the pieces that were written specifically for me have been big enough productions to where you would have seen them.
And we do have a video question coming in from Jamie Farrar. Let me try and take that real quickly.
I wanted to see if there was anything that you wanted to cover with Mike that wasn't covered in the show. And I just wanted to say that NCIS means a lot to me. It was my dad's favorite show, and yeah.
Muse, you want to address that?
I'm dying to meet that woman that Mike married twice. I'm dying. She's talking about covering something that was said but not, you know, covered. That would be it to me. I would want to meet that woman that Mike married twice.
Is it difficult staying involved with church when you're out in Hollywood and so much is going on? How do you handle that?
No, it's not difficult. I know people would like for you to believe it's difficult because it's Hollywood and all that, but it's not. There are a lot of God-fearing people in Hollywood. And there are a lot of Christian people in Hollywood. There are a lot of Muslim people in Hollywood. There's a lot of there's a lot of different religions out here who practice their religion on a daily basis, and don't let everything you see on the Kardashian show influence you. There are people that go to church out here in Los Angeles just like everywhere else in the country, and it's not any more difficult here than anywhere else. You know, when I started recovering from alcohol, I found that there was help for me just about on every corner. And there was, you know, I think if you're looking for a church, you're going to find one. If you're looking for a bar, you can find one of those. So they're both as close as what your efforts render.
One last question here. What do you think makes NCIS so popular? And we'll close after this question.
I think what makes NCIS real popular is the fact that it has the brilliance of an audience being able to take very little or get into it a whole lot. You can watch one episode of NCIS and be very entertained by the program, or you can decide after you've seen NCIS that you like a particular character, and you can start watching the episodes and find out more about that particular character and feel like you're a part of the bunch. So I think one of the real successes of the show is it's been so creative to establish a show where you can get a little bit of it or you can get a whole bunch of it, and I think that's one of the keys to its success.
Alrighty, well, Muse, we certainly appreciate you entertaining us tonight for well over 2 hours. We started this at 7 o'clock Eastern time, and it's a little bit past 9 o'clock Eastern. Time really flies when you're having lots of fun, huh? But this has been a real treat for us.
It does.
And any last words you want to say, Muse, before we go?
I'd like to say thanks to all the people who watch NCIS and follow the show. The people that you see on that show are worth your admiration. Mark Harmon is just a wonderful guy. You couldn't pick a better show to be a fan of, and I appreciate your watching the show, and believe me, so does Mark and the gang. They all appreciate you watching the show, and they love you as fans.
Ashley, thanks for joining us. Muse, likewise, thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to join us, and maybe we'll see each other again soon. Join Ashley and I every Tuesday, 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, for NCIS Fanatic Live. We talk NCIS and NCIS Los Angeles and take your questions live on vocal.com. Find our show at live.ncisfanatic.com.